Hello everyone,
hope all of you are sound and safe at home. Let's continue with the support reaction. Let's have a small recap. So in the last session, we had seen the free body diagram. We know for analyzing the body under equilibrium, it's important to draw first the free body diagram. Free body diagram is the diagram which is isolated from its contact surfaces but showing all the reactions acting, including the external forces as well as the internal reactions acting on the body. So we had seen the different types of supports: roller support, hinged support, and fixed support, simple support, cable support, etc. We had seen the types of beams depending upon the kind of support it carries. Simply supported beam, beam with one end roller, another end hinged, both end hinged, cantilever beam, propped cantilever, overhanging, and the fixed beam. So, pinned or hinged support, it looks like the representation. It restricts the movement both in horizontal and the vertical direction. So, it has two reactions. Roller support representation, you can see in the second column. It offers only the resistance for the vertical movement. So, reaction will be vertical reaction. If the roller support is provided horizontally, then the reaction will be horizontal. Okay. Fixed support, it offers resistance both for the linear as well as the translatory motion. That means all the three kinds of motion are restricted: horizontal, vertical, and the rotation. Hence, three reactions for the fixed support. This all you have to remember while drawing the free body diagram. So different types of the loads, we have seen the point loads. If the loads are concentrated at a point, they are called as the point load. We have seen the distributed load. If the load is distributed over a considerable length, it is called as the distribution load. Again, in the distribution load, we have seen the uniformly distributed load. Even the rectangular loading is called as the UDL, and we have seen the uniformly varying load. It can be triangle or it can be trapezoidal loading. We have seen the varying load, the load in the curved pattern. So these are all the different types of the load. We know how to find the equivalent load or the resultant load of UDL, U and UVL. Right. So this is all what we have seen in the last session. In this session, let's see how to analyze the beams and how to find the reaction support reactions. So the steps: draw the free body diagram, that is depending upon the type of the support, show the number of the reactions, and if any UDL, UVL, you can even note the point of action of the equivalent load of UDL and UVL. Then we use the equation of static equilibrium. What are the conditions of equilibrium? Three conditions: sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma h is equal to 0, that means algebraic summation of all the horizontal forces or the forces acting along the x direction are 0. Sigma fy is equal to 0, that means algebraic summation of all the forces acting along the y direction or vertical direction, that is sigma v, is equal to 0. Sigma mz is equal to 0, that is the algebraic summation of moment of all the forces about any one point is equal to zero. Okay, if the compound beams means two or three beams connected each other at the point of connection, we show the reactions equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So we use the equation of static equilibrium for each free body diagram to solve for the unknowns. So let's see an simple example. Simply supported beam is given. Two loads are acting, W1 and W2. So they are acting at a distance of L1 and L2 from the end A. First thing, you have to observe the beam. You have to observe what kind of loadings are there, what kind of support is there. According to the kind of the support, you have to draw the reactions. Here it is the simple support, only one vertical reaction. It offers, let RA is equal to reaction at A and RB is the reaction at B. So, to analyze the beam, we have to apply the conditions of equilibrium, that is sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V is equal to 0 and sigma M is equal to 0. So, as there you can see in the beam, there are no horizontal forces, so sigma H is equal to 0 automatically satisfied here as there are no other horizontal forces. So, sigma Fy is equal to 0 and sigma M is equal to 0 are the only two conditions we need to apply. So by applying sigma V is equal to 0 or sigma Fy is equal to 0, so that means we have to add up all the vertical forces. What are the vertical forces acting on the beam? Ra, Rb, they are acting upwards, and W1, W2, they are acting downwards. So, according to our sign convention, upward forces are positive, downward forces are negative. So, Ra plus Rb minus W1 minus W2 is equal to 0. That means Ra plus Rb is equal to W1 plus W2. When you take the W1 and W2 to the other side of the equation, equation becomes Ra plus Rb is equal to W1 plus W2. Next, we apply the conditions, sigma M is equal to 0, that is the moment about any point of all the forces should be 0. As the distances are measured from point A, let's take the moment about point A. So, taking the moment of all the forces about the point A, W1 into L1 plus W2 into L2, they are producing the clockwise moment. What is our sign convention? Clockwise moments are positive, anti-clockwise moments are negative. Minus Rb into L, that is the anti-clockwise moment, that is equal to 0. Or W1 into L1 plus W2 into L2 is equal to Rb into L. So, Rb is equal to W1 into L1 plus W2 into L2 by L. So, we have already got, if we know the intensities of W1 and W2, we can calculate Rb from the equation 1, that is sigma Fy is equal to 0. We have got the Ra plus Rb is equal to W1 plus W2. By substituting, we get now the Ra is equal to W1 plus W2 minus Rb. This is how we find the support reactions. Okay. Let's see some. I have taken simple examples in this session. This is similar to the example just now we have seen. A simply supported beam AB of length 6 meter and carries point loads 3 kN and 6 kN at a distance of 2 meter and 4 meter from the left end A. Find the reactions at A and B. This is what we have just seen the example, similar way. their intensities were given as W1 and W2. Here the magnitude of the loads are given. So span of the beam is given 6 meter. Let RA reaction at A and RB be the reaction at B. So let's take the moment of all the forces about A. That is, we are applying the condition sigma m is equal to 0. RB into 6 minus 3 into 2 minus 6 into 4 is equal to 0. Actually, this is minus RB into 6 plus 3 into 2 plus 6 into 4 is equal to 0. So RB, you get it as 5 kilonewton. It doesn't matter if you take to the other side of the equation, the negative sign becomes positive. So it doesn't matter, but you should not write all as positive or all as negative. Okay. So RB is equal to 5 kilonewton. So now apply the condition sigma Fy is equal to 0. So RA plus only 4 vertical loads, RA, RB and 3 and 6. RA plus RB is equal to 3 plus 6. We have found out RB. Substitute in this, we get RA as 4 kilonewton. Simple problem. As we need not to apply sigma H is equal to 0 as there are no horizontal forces. Okay. Let's see the another example. This is of the UDL. A simply supported beam AB of length 9 meter carries a uniformly distributed load of 10 kilonewton per meter for a distance of 6 meter from the left end. Calculate the reactions at A and B. So span beam is of the length 9 meter, simply supported beam. So only two reactions, one reaction at each end. UDL is acting, please observe the diagram, UDL is not spread over the length of 9 meter, it is just for 6 meter, okay. It is not acting over the span of 9 meter, UDL is acting only for a length of 6 meter. So, span is 9 meter, rate of UDL is 10 kilonewton per meter. Length of UDL is 6. So if we have to find out the resultant of the equivalent load, it acts at the center, that is 6 by 2, and the total intensity of that UDL is 10 into 6, that is 60 kilonewton. It acts at the center of 6 meter. Please observe, it is not acting at the center of 9 meter. UDL is acting just over a length of 6 meter, center point of the 6 meter, that is 6 by 2, 3 meter from either side of A and C. Okay. So total load is 6 into 10, 60 kilonewton. The load of 60 kilonewton will be acting at the middle point of AC. That is at a distance of 6 by 2, that is equal to 3 meter from A. So let RA is reaction at A and RB reaction at B. Let's apply the moment sigma m is equal to 0. Let's take the moment about the point A. See here, it is easier to take the moment about the point A. We can take the moment about the point B also. But since the load is attached from the beginning from the point A, it is easier to take the moment about the point A. Okay, so it is considered here the moment about the point A, sigma m at about A is equal to 0. What are the moments? RB into 9, right? Minus RB into 9. Plus 6 into 10 into 3. See, the 60 kilonewton total load, that is 10 into 6, is acting at the center, that is at a distance of 3 meter from A, that is equal to 0, or RB is equal to 20 kilonewton. Next, apply the condition sigma Fy is equal to 0. How many vertical loads? 3 vertical loads. Ra plus Rb minus 60 is equal to 0. Or Ra plus Rb is equal to 60. How it is 60? Intensity of the UDL is 10. It is over a length of 6 meters. So 10 into 6, that is 60. We have already found out Rb. Hence, Ra is equal to 60 minus Rb. That is 60 minus 20 is equal to 40 kilonewton. This is how we find the support reactions for the equivalent load. Next, let's see the next example. It is the example of the UVL. It is the example of triangular loading spread over a length of 6 meters. One end intensity is 0, another end intensity is 25 kN per meter. It is uniformly varying from 0 to 25. The beam is hinged and roller supported beam. That means in the free body diagram, in the previous examples what we have seen, they are all simply supported beam. Here the beam is hinged and roller supported beam. We know that at the hinged end there will be two reactions, Ra and Rb, Fya and or Afy and Afx, or Va and Ha. At the end B, there will be only one reaction, it is the roller support, that is Vb. So here Ray, Rax and Rb, it is denoted. And the equivalent load, we know what is the equivalent load, that is nothing but the area of the triangle, that is half into 25 into 6. 6 is the span, 25 is the height, so you get it as 75 kilonewton. And where does it act? It acts at from the maximum intensity, and it acts at a distance of L by 3, that is 6 by 3. From the zero intensity end, it is acts at a distance of 2L by 3, that is 2 into 6 by 3, that is 4 meter. Here it is 2 meter. Okay. So, next step is to take the moments to find the reaction at the cross supports. Let's take the moment about the end A. If you want, you can take the moment about the end B also. So what are the forces producing moment? Rb minus Rb into 6 plus the UDL. The moment of the UDL is half into 25 into 6. It acts from the end A, it acts at a distance of 2/3 of 6. That is equal to 0. You can see here Rax and Ray. They are passing through the point A, so they do not produce any moment. So Rb, we get it as 50 kilonewton. Next step is to apply another condition. Again here, only Rax is there, so there is no need to apply sigma H is equal to 0. Only one force, yes, Rax is equal to 0. If we apply sigma Fy is equal to 0, how many vertical forces? 3 vertical forces, Ray, Rb, and the equivalent load of the triangular loading, that is 75 kilonewton. So Ray plus Rb, they are acting upward, hence positive, minus half into 25 into 6, that is 75. But we have found out Rb, that is 50. So Ray is equal to 75 minus 50, that is 25 kilonewton. Okay, as I told, only one horizontal force, Rax. Calculate the reactions for the trapezoidal load for the beam shown in figure. So, I have shown already this kind of example while showing the types of the loads. Right, what we have to do? We have to divide this into two loads, one rectangular loading and another triangular. So divide the trapezoid into rectangle, that is 10 into 5, 1 end intensity is 10, other end intensity is, so here you divide the rectangle into 10 into 10, so of intensity 10, so the total loading acts at the center, that is 2.5 meter from either end, so under loading it varies from 10 to 30, so the triangular loading will have the intensity 30 minus 10, 10 we have taken out for the rectangle, so the triangular loading will have the maximum intensity 20, other side intensity is 0, so the equivalent load is nothing but the area of the triangle, that is half into 20 into 5. It again acts at a distance of L by 3 from the maximum intensity end, that is 5 by 3, that is equal to 1.67 meter. Or if you are calculating the distance from the point A, it is 2L by 3. Okay, 2 into 5 by 3. So, let's consider one load at a time. Here, I have considered only the rectangular loading. Taking the moment about the end A, the reactions are considered as RA1 and RB. Here the beam is roller support at the end A and the hinged support at the end B. So one reaction at the end A and two reactions at the end B. So let's take the moment about the end A. If you want, you can take the moment about the end B also. Nothing problem. No problem at all. So minus RBY1 into 5 plus 50 into 2.5. 50 is nothing but the total intensity of that rectangular loading 10 into 5. So you get RBY1. So next apply the another condition, sigma Fy is equal to 0. So RA1 plus RBY1 is equal to minus 50 is equal to 0. Only three vertical loadings. So RBY we have already found out. So RA1 will be 50 minus 25, that is 25 kilonewton. Now let's consider the triangular loading. So let the reaction will be RA2 at the end A and RBY2 and RBX2 at the end B. Okay, let's take the moment about the end A. So here again minus RBY2 into 5 plus 50, that is the total intensity of the triangular loading, half into 20 into 5, 50 into 2 third of 5, that is the length from the point A, centroidal distance from the point B, it is 1 third of L from is the length from here, it is this distance is 2 third of L, okay, that is 2 third of 5. So that RBY2 you get it as 33.4 kilonewton. So next apply the another condition, sigma Fy is equal to 0. Here again the sigma H is equal to 0 or sigma Fx is equal to 0 is not valid as there are no other horizontal forces, only one horizontal force. So that will be again is equal to 0. So we are applying the second condition, sigma Fy is equal to 0. Three vertical loadings, again RA2, RBY2 and 50. Add them up according to the sign convention. Upward forces positive, downward forces negative. So we have already found out RBY2. Substitute, we get RA2 as 16.6 kilonewton. So now RA is RA1 plus RA2. That is the combination of both these vertical and rectangular and the UVL load. So RA1 we had got it as 25, Ra2 16.6, add up, you get the reaction at A. Similarly, the reaction at B, RbY1 plus RbY2, you get Rb as 58.4 kilonewton. As no horizontal load is there, therefore RbY1 and RbY2 are zero. Let's see one more example. Determine the reactions at supports A and B. Here the combination of the loadings, actually you get the problems like this. You don't get the beams with single loading, you get the beams with multiple loading. It may contain point load, UDL, couple, UVL, inclined load, everything. Okay. This is one such kind of problem. Hinged and roller supported beam. It carries two point loads of 24 kN at a distance of 0.6 meter from in between them, and a UDL or the rectangular loading 12 kN per meter for a length of 1.8 meter. That means the total length of the beam is 3.6 meter. Okay, so here the NDA is hinged supported, so there will be two reactions. End B is roller supported, there will be one reaction. So the loads acting on the beam, point loads and the UDL. So we have to find the reaction at the hinge supports and the reaction at the roller support. This is the free body diagram. As I have told, at the hinged support you will have the two reactions and at the roller support one reaction, and the equivalent load of that UDL 12 kN per meter over a length of 1.8 meter is nothing but the area of that rectangle, that is 12 into 1.8, you get it as 21.6 kN. And it acts at the center of that 1.8 meter, that is 1.8 by 2, that is 0.9 meter from either end B and E. So that's what I have just explained. UDL can be replaced by the equivalent point load. Okay. It acts at the center of the span. So applying now the conditions of equilibrium, sigma MA is equal to 0. 24 into 0.6, that is the first 24 kN acting at the point C. The next load is the another 24 kN acting at the point D. It is at a distance of 1.2 meter, that is 0.6 plus 0.6. So 24 into 1.2. Next is the UDL, resultant load of UDL, that is 21.6 kN. So it acts at a distance of, if you from the 3.6 meter, if you take out 0.9 meter, okay, you get that length as 2.7 meter. So 21.6 into 2.7. You have to be very careful in calculating the distances while finding the moments. Okay, another force producing the moment is Rb, that is minus Rb into 3.6, that is equal to 0. We are applying the condition sigma MA is equal to 0. You can take the moment about the point B also. So if you take the moment about the point A, we get Rb, value of Rb. If you take the moment about the point B, we get the value of Ra or Ay. Okay. So we get Rb as 28.2 kN. Next, apply the another condition, sigma Fy is equal to 0. So what are the vertical forces? Ay. 124, another 24 and another 21.6, all acting downwards, and another Rb. So combine all of them add, find the summation ay plus rb minus 24 minus 24 minus 21.6. You get ay. Rb we had just now, we had found out that has 28.2 kilonewton. So ay is equal to 41.4 kilonewton. Sigma fx is equal to 0. There are no other horizontal loadings. Only ax is the horizontal loading. So ax is equal to 0 kilonewton. Okay. This is how we analyze the support reactions. So total reaction at Ra, since Ax is 0, Ra will be Ay only, that is 41.4 kilonewton. Otherwise, we will see in the next classes how the total reaction, how to find the total reaction when both Ax and Ay are there. Okay. That's all for today's session. Thank you. Please solve all these problems. These problems, what I have shown here today, is for your practice. If you practice this well, how to find the, how to solve when the triangular loads are there, when the trapezoidal loads are there, when the UDLs are there. If you have understood the concept, then it is very easier when multiple loadings are acting on the beam to solve, because the distances measurement is very important here, because you may have seen that your answers depends on the condition, how you are applying the moment force into distance from the moment center. Whatever the moment center you have selected, from that point you have to calculate the distances. So don't make any mistakes. Please practice this. These problems are for your practice. In the next session, let's see some more complex problems with the multiple loadings on the beams. Okay. Thank you.